holding a Seagull Entourage Dreadnought. The Entourage is a very wide range for us. We've got folks, parlours, dreads. We've got a mini jumbo, which is sounds a bit confusing, but it's
mini jumbo. Yeah. Small elephant.
Yeah, yeah. And we've got a lot of cutaway electros, and the range is huge. But the what we do with the Entourage series is the original series, and a lot of the Coastline series is the wider fingerboard. But like the Excursion series, not everyone likes that extra width. So this is a traditional kind of nut width, which
slightly less.
Yeah, yeah. It's 1.72, so it's a wee bit more comfy. If you don't like the width. And what we do is we put a stain on that. When we're making the guitars, we do this thing, select pressure testing, which is quite simply, when we make the tops, we use a gauge and we measure the resistance. And the theory is that the more resistance, the more sound you're going to get, the sweet the sound's going to be, because it's going to resonate more and you can raise it lightly.
Yeah.
So everything is pressure tested and graded, and the stuff below the minimum amount of resistance is chucked. But cedar can be quite, how would you call it, aesthetically, quite, you know, different colours. You can get these mineral stains in them. So what we do on this range, which sits below the original series in price point, we put a burst on, we put some colour on. So it's a great sounding top, but there's going to be some lines in it maybe. So what we do is we stain it and colour it. So it means we're not chucking perfectly good sounding wood out for aesthetic reasons. So if you like the cut, and it's a nice burst, yeah. Like a cherry burst. Take it away, Jim. Sound like to you? It sounded, it's a bit more mellower to my ears than the original series, but
it's quite a sad sounding guitar.
Yeah. Melancholic,
I like that. I like the sound like that for the sort of Gillian Welch and David Rawlings kind of stuff.
I know exactly. Yeah.
It doesn't get in the way. It's not overly bass heavy or anything like that.
Yeah. Yeah, and it hasn't got that real sort of zingy sparkle that, yeah.
Yeah, I do a lot of that, and David Rawlings says that. It comes from Chet. Right, okay. Where you play the scales. So you let the notes ring, you know. And I like the guitar where you...
Well, the one of the things when I do trade shows and talk to people is, despite being around for 40 odd years and making a lot of guitars and being a big guitar company, a lot of people haven't heard of the brand. We've got Seagull, we've got Simon & Patry, we've got Art & Luthery, we've got Norman, we've got a nylon string band called Apache as well that Guitar do. And they've, Robert Gaudin's philosophy is, it's all about the guitars, you know. It's not really about the glossy brochures or the advertising.
Yeah.
There's something that's good about that, because it's all the money's in the guitar. It's not
well,
in the,
everything you do in the PR or anything puts the price up on the guitar.
That's the thing, yeah. And it's that's a problem. But that, I suppose that's the thing about if we're sort of under the radar company, even though we've been going around for 40 years and we're, you know, big company now. That people are still coming. discovering the brand for the first time. So, but when you do find it, you get an awful lot of value for money. That's the good thing.
Cool.